Hey, Most Amazing Top 10 family, I'm your host, Jay Duran, and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. When you're doing your online shopping, you're usually thinking, will these jeans make my butt look hot? Or will these random knickknacks fill the empty, loveless void in my heart? But the last thing you'll be wondering is whether or not the items you're about to purchase have an evil spirit attached to them. Unless that's the kind of stuff you're shopping for, which in that case, everyone has their hobbies. And to make sure your purchases are a little safer, I'm bringing you today's list of top 10 scary possessed objects you won't believe. As always, make sure you like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. And stick around for the whole video because I'm going to be doing some more pet shout out. Remember, if you want me to shout out your pets, come hit me up on Instagram. It's gonna take me a time to work through all of these because my inbox is like packed full of pets right now, but hey, that's what it is. And I love doing it because it's so silly and dumb, and I also get to look at pets all day. Also, if you need more Most Amazing Top 10 content, come check us out on the Instagram for Most Amazing Top 10. And if anyone out there wants some Most Amazing Top 10 merch, you can check out the link below. Use the offer code MA10 for $5 off, which means you can grab a shirt for 10 bucks. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. We are going to kick off this list with an object that sounds like it's the name of a hack 80s metal band. For the number 10 spot, we have Screaming Skull. This thing is exactly what it sounds like. It's a skull and it screams. Well, the skull itself doesn't scream, but it has an angry spirit attached to it, which lets out a scream something fierce. If you're ever in the cute little town of Burton Agnes, England, and you're in the mood to scare yourself so bad you pee a little, then you should go check out Elizabeth Manor. This home houses so many items with long historic backstories, but the item that brings tourists coming year after year is the Screaming Skull. It's the skull of Catherine Ann Griffith. She was living in the home back in the 1600s, and it was also the place she died. Catherine was murdered in a very brutal way. In 1620, she was attacked by a gang of bullies, and they beat her so bad that not long after she got home, she passed away. Now her skull is kept in the home. Sort of a strange souvenir to keep, but everyone wants to be remembered, I guess. Now it's said that if you try to remove the skull from the house, you will hear the blood-curdling scream of her ghost. Unless you want to anger someone from the afterlife, I would suggest leaving the skull alone. At number 9, we have the Hands Resist Him. I feel like we could do a whole video just on possessed or cursed paintings. There are so many of them. You could decorate your house with more spirits than a cemetery. The Hands Resist Him is a famously haunted painting. I mean, just look at it. Right off the bat, we have one of the creepiest paintings I have ever seen. There's a boy in it who looks like he strangles pets as a hobby, and then we got a creepy doll girl and these ghost hands pressed up against a window. This is the kind of painting you find in an old house at the beginning of a horror movie. The artist made this painting as a guide for people who have passed on or who are asleep. And I guess it worked because this painting has a whole bunch of weird stuff attached to it. Apparently, just from looking at it, people feel nauseous, and the two people who originally reviewed the piece died. I wonder if they gave it a bad review, and maybe the painting wanted to kill him because of that. If the painting is your home, you can expect to see some super weird things. Some people have said that they've seen hands move around on the painting, or figures disappear from the painting. The creepiest thing is the ghost boy in the painting will sometimes appear in front of it, like in real life. I would assume that this young boy's spirit is attached to this piece, and he is the reason all these weird things are happening. At number 8, we have Ghost Cane. The ghost cane sounds less like a haunted item and more like a sex move you read about on Urban Dictionary. This item gained popularity when it went up for auction on eBay. People started bidding for it like crazy when the owner, Mary Anderson, said she was selling it because her son was convinced that his dead grandfather would use it to walk around at night. She said that she didn't believe the item was haunted, but her son insisted that he had seen Papa go for a stroll in the night holding the cane. And of course, people love these sorts of things, so it got over 100 bids. What if Grandpa's soul really was attached to the cane? He would get shipped off to a new place, he doesn't know anyone, and then he'd be walking around like a spectral ghost being like, where's my family? I wanna haunt my family. That's actually kinda sad. At number 7, we have Ann Baker's wedding dress. It seems like if you ever wanna make a ghost real, just piss off a girl on her wedding day, or right before she gets married. Or even in this case, just tell her she can't marry someone she wants, and she'll carry a grudge for 60 years and then become a ghost when she dies. In other words, don't mess with a lady on her special day unless you want a ghost to torment you for the rest of your life. Ann Baker's wedding dress is locked up in a glass case in her old home in Pennsylvania. Her home was turned into a museum and the dress is the main attraction. In 1849, Anna fell in love with a man who had commoner status. He was an iron worker. She was so excited to marry him that she bought her wedding dress. However, her father didn't want her daughter to marry a commoner. Anna and her family were the high class, so Anna fell into a depression and vowed to never love again. She died single in 1849. 14. It said if you watch the dress during the witching hour, it will start to shake. It might be a cheap trick installed by the people who work the museum, or it's actually the ghost of this pissed off Anna all these years later. At number 6, we have the Belcourt Castle Armor. If you're ever in Boston and you get bored of watching all their sports teams clean house and bring home 12 more championships, then maybe you should head over to the Belcourt Castle. Not as exciting as Tom Brady hosting up another Lombardi, but it's still pretty cool. This castle has all sorts of paranormal activity going on inside it. One of the most famous is the Screaming Armor, another screaming thing. It's an entire set of plate armor that has been heard letting out horrible wails. People speculate this is from the man who died in the armor. He was stabbed in the eye with a spear through one of the eye slits. This guy must have been so pissed off. You spend all day getting ready, putting on this plate armor, and then this dude slips a spear in the only opening? His last words were probably, "Ah, come on!" At number 5, we have the Belcourt Castle chairs. I wanted to pull a few more possessed items out of the Belcourt Castle because this place has a lot of ghosts hanging around in inanimate objects. There are a few chairs in the Belcourt Castle that have ghosts still sitting in them, and they don't want you to take their spot. People who have sat in these chairs have passed out, felt nauseous, felt an electric shock go through their body, and have even been thrown out of the chairs. The ghosts are like, "Hey, come on, have a seat." And then after they throw you to the ground, they're like, "Psych, you thought." At number 4, we have the Anguished Man. This possessed painting has one of the most famous backstories of any haunted piece of art. Apparently, the artist mixed his own blood with the paint to make this picture. I mean, I think that would really give you like a one-tone color palette to the whole thing, but to each his own, I'm not an artist. Also, I don't think this would be a good selling point. Like, "Do you want to buy this painting? I put my own blood in it." "No thanks, man. I'm gonna buy one of the millions of other paintings that have zero blood in them. That's just me though." Well, the artist wasn't worried about whether or not this would do well in the market because he killed himself right after the completion of the painting. Now many people think his tormented soul is attached to this artwork. It said whoever owns the painting will hear voices at night, see strange images in their home, and have vivid nightmares. Wow, all these horrible hauntings in just one painting. Who could pass up this deal? You better get two just in case one breaks. At number 3, we have the Conjure Chest. This chest is rooted in brutality and revenge. The story goes that the chest was made by an African-American slave by the name of Hosea. It was an order from his master, Jacob Cooley, to make it for his unborn son. Cooley was an awful man. After Hosea finished the chest, Cooley beat him to death because he thought it was poorly crafted. Well, Hosea's fellow slaves were not going to take this sitting down, and they performed a ritual on the chest using owl's blood. This gave power to the now dead Hosea's spirit, and after Cooley's son was born, he died before he reached the age of 2. It's said that 7 other people have died because of this chest, and now it's locked away in a museum. I wouldn't worry about touching it though, because the spell has been lifted through another ritual and Hosea's spirit is set free. At number 2, we have haunted bunk beds. Man, ghosts won't let you enjoy anything. Even when you're just trying to have a nice place for your kids to sleep, a ghost is trying to ruin it. Also, bunk beds are like some of the most wholesome things on the planet. You can't haunt that. That's like haunting a puppy or a rainbow. Alan and Debbie Tallman bought these bunk beds for their kids way back in 1987. It was supposed to be a good time, but it quickly turned into the most horrifying part of their home. For the next few months, a bunch of strange paranormal stuff would happen. It started small with the radio randomly changing stations, and stuff would move around in their home. Then things started to get a little worse. Their kids started to get sick out of nowhere. One night, one of the Tallman kids woke up and saw a witch in his room. Not the kind of visitor you want hanging around when you're sleeping. Witches aren't known for being super chill. They usually want your organs to make some sort of potion. Alan even reported seeing a giant fire in the garage. He left to grab a fire extinguisher, but then when he returned, the fire was gone. This possessed bunk bed was even inducing these hallucinations. Eventually, the family had enough and they burned these bunk beds to the ground. Because? And at number 1, we have the Bassano Vase. Once again, don't mess with a lady on her wedding day. Her ghost will be so angry and so powerful, it will kill your entire bloodline. The story behind the Bassano Vase is it was a wedding gift for a beautiful bride to be back in the 15th century. It was a solid silver vase, so a pretty ballin' gift. Unfortunately, the young woman about to get married died on her wedding day before she got to enjoy it, and her ghost was like, "Oh, hell no, you haven't heard the last of me." The vase got passed from family member to family member. Everyone who owned it died within a few months. So they buried the damn thing and the ghost stayed attached to it. They even left a note with the vase that said, "Beware, this vase brings death." And then it was gone until 1987. Someone dug it up and sold it at an auction, and her ghost was probably like, "I'm back, baby. Who's ready to die?" The vase got passed through 4 more people, all of them dying within less than 3 months. Some of the people were in their 30s and had zero health problems. After the Bassano vase was on round 2, killing its 4th person, the new owner then gave it to the police, who put it in a lead box and buried it in an unknown location. Nobody wanted to mess with this thing at all. They should have melted it down or something. Alright everyone, that is our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in, and as promised, I'm going to be giving some more shoutouts to the most amazing top 10 families' pets. I love doing this. Aaron wanted a shout out for a collection of companions. There's Lightning, Buttercup, Snugs, Cinnamon, and Pepper. I'm not sure which one's which, but they're all super cute. Another member of the Most Amazing Top 10 family wanted a shout out for their 2 super cute bunnies. I like how they're on leashes. Like, I didn't even know you could walk bunnies. That's so amazing. I like their little fur and their hair and their ears and stuff. Here's Kimberly Marshall's big fluffer, Kara. Look at those eyes. They're so nice. 14 out of 10. Beautiful dog. This member of the Most Amazing Top 10 family didn't give me the name of their floofer, but I had to include him because he's a little king. Look at him all wrapped up in a blanket. I know it's melting my heart. And finally, Bridget wanted a shout out for a cat, Mishka, who's a big old chonker. Look at that cat. She's thick with 2 C's. Thick girl. Anyways, that is all we have for you today. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. If anyone at home needs more Most Amazing Top 10 content, go check us out on Instagram. And if you're looking for some merch, use the link below. Use the offer code MA10 to get $5 off, which means you can grab a shirt for 10 bucks. Such a good deal. Until next time, I've been Chaterana. I hope everyone at home isn't cursed with anything. If you are, I'm not gonna hang out with you.